professional. Or if we're in America, I think they call these sports jackets. I'd hear that phrase in movies when I was a kid or TV shows. I just gotta get a sports jacket. Like, what the hell's a sports jacket? I'd always think it was like a letter jacket, you know, with a big, the American footballers wearing with their letter, their initial on the back. But no, apparently a blazer in America is a sports jacket. So I'm wearing my sports jacket. Anyways, today we're going to go over a football ramble. It's all part of my new plan for the year, which I will reveal on Monday. Basically like a timetable of what you can expect, when you can expect it, what days, this day, that day, tomorrow, the other day, back then, last week, next week, whenever. And that is how we're going to roll, so you know, before I do, what to expect on the 3rd of April, okay? Even though we're only on the 3rd of January. My lips are so dry. Oh well, sod it, I'm not a woman, I don't use Vaseline. I tried to, whilst I was ill last week, my lips were really chapped. I thought I'd put a bit of Vaseline on. I don't know, women do it, and men. I don't know, it felt horrible. Right, so, let's go back a few days to Christmas, yeah? I just thought about this a moment ago. You don't see kids doing this anymore. When I was a kid, my favourite present for either birthdays or Christmas, and when I was a kid, this was a popular thing. It was to get a full football kit. Now, I was not spoiled as a kid by any stretch of the imagination, and they weren't cheap. But me and my dad, if a new Man United top was coming out, which it did every summer, ready for the new season, he'd buy us both the new top. But my birthday was in May. Well, it still is in May, hasn't changed. And the season obviously started in August, so they'd have the new kit released. So for my birthday, I usually got a full kit. So we're talking t-shirt, shorts, socks, and I would wear them all the time. I'd wear them to school underneath my uniform. At lunchtime, we'd whip our uniform off, and I'd be running around in our football kits. I'd wear them after school, wherever I could. I'd be wearing my football kit all the time. I used to get them for Christmas as well sometimes. But you don't see it these days. Like, it's very rare you'll see a kid wearing a football shirt out and about. So odd. I know they're ridiculously expensive these days. Probably what it cost my dad for a full kit. You can probably only get a t-shirt for now. But you know, the awkward thing I feel is when you see grown men wearing football shirts, it's so odd. As a kid, I was accepted, in my opinion, because I used to see lots of adults wearing them. But nowadays, if I saw an adult walking on the street in a football shirt, I'd think, mate, come on, grow up a little bit. I need to coffee a guy's out. It's a bad one. At the minute, it's just like a cough and a headache that's hanging about. But this cough is like really deep down. I don't know, smokers handle it. When you smokers cough, oh, thankfully I don't smoke. Only the occasional special cigarette. Very rarely though. Right guys, let's get into today's ramble. Wow, the hair is a bit of a mess, isn't it? Now I know why I wore a hat for so long. Hell, getting it cut anyhow, so it don't matter. Right, as part of the sports jacket ensemble, we go along with a professional looking fedora. Well, how professional does that look? Do you want to give me a job? Do you want to give me a job? As your professional ASMR rambler. Ramble. Sound effects. Very slowly open the folder with its nice silver zip. And it's open. 7-8 years, I'm guessing. Maybe longer, maybe not. In that time, we've seen other clubs come up and change management 2, 3, 4 times. Some with degrees of success, some with not. West Ham, Pellegrini, in and out. Pilic, in and out. Moyes, once in and out. Now Moyes is back. Leicester, Ranieri in, wins the league next season, does shit, gets gone. Club who well comes in, starts off well, does shit, goes. Rodgers in, now they're doing well. Aston Villa, I believe, will be coming up soon with Dean Smith out the door. There's been countless teams. Tottenham, Pochettino, for God's sake. See you later, Poch. Mopo, see you later. Or rather, no, Mo. See you later. Chelsea, Conte, wins the league, bye bye. Sarri, does shit, bye bye. This is what happens, this is the way of the world. Even Man United, Van Gaal, shit, bye bye. Jose, crap, bye bye. Oli, you're one of us, you can have a bye for a few years. Okay, not a good example. But Bournemouth fans, surely they are now realising that the only way is down with Eddie Howe. And how can that be with Eddie Howe? Well, I'll tell you how. Eddie Howe, this is how. You're not doing a good job, mate. I hate to break it to you. You can go on all the time about injury problems. You're a Premier League manager. You have been there for a lot of years. You've had enough time to build up a decent squad. Let me put this into numbers. 35 million. Not 3.5 million. 35 million. They gave to Liverpool for two players. Can you name them? Because they've had a few from Liverpool, but can you name the two I'm on about? Nope. Probably not, because neither of them are exactly prolific, are they? Jordan Ibe, where the hell's he at? Where the hell is this lad at? He cost him like 15 million quid. You don't hear anything of him. I'll tell you. I'll tell you Jordan Ibe's numbers. I don't just do this for fun. I've got the details. Jordan Ibe, 16.2 million. From Liverpool to Bournemouth. He, for Liverpool, made 57 appearances, scoring 4 goals. Okay. For Bournemouth, he has played 3.5 seasons at Bournemouth. He's had there. Hasn't really played 3.5 seasons, but he's been there for 3.5 seasons. In 86 appearances, he's got 5 goals. 5 goals in 86 games. And so altogether 9 goals between the two clubs, and that is in 143 appearances, 9 goals. Not exactly what you'd call prolific, is it? What's going on with the hair here? Christ, I need a haircut today. It's not good, is it? Anyways, do you know the other person I'm talking about here, other than Jordan Ibe? Do you? Yes, of course. It's Mr. England's top goal scorer himself, Dominic Solanke. Okay, where's he in this one? But never made a start for Chelsea. He had one appearance. I think it was off the. I'm pretty sure it was off the bench. Never scored for them. For Liverpool, they got him on a free transfer, was compensation or whatever. 27 appearances, 1 goal for Liverpool. Now listen to that, okay? So that is 27 appearances and he scored 1 goal. He ended up at Vitesse Arnhem, I think that was on loan from Chelsea at some point, where he made 25 appearances and got 7 goals over in Holland. Okay, so we are talking 53 appearances between Chelsea, Liverpool and Vitesse. 53 appearances, he scored 8 goals and only one of them was for Liverpool, with 7 being in Holland. Eddie bloody Howe felt that was a good enough reason to go out and spend 20 million quid on that. 20 million pounds on a striker who had only ever scored once in England. What the hell is he thinking? He has now made 82 appearances for Bournemouth. He's had 29 appearances. be so freaking stupid with our money. Think about it here. We need a striker who's going to score. And you're bringing in Dominic Solanke. Where's your head at? Seriously, where is your head at? To make matters worse, they had Lise. Hang on, bear with me, guys. To make matters worse, they paid 5.8 million for Lise Mousse at Bournemouth before letting go on to Sheffield United. I think Sheffield United paid like 10 million for him in Bournemouth, at Bournemouth in 71 appearances. He got five goals in 71 games. When I wrote this a couple of days ago, so before last night, so I don't know if he played last night against Liverpool, I'm not sure. Before that, he had played 18 times for Sheffield United. Guess how many goals he got? Five goals in 18 games at Bournemouth. Five goals in 71 games. Does not make a good reading at all for Eddie Howe and his motivational skills, in my opinion. This coffee's getting on my nerves now. But then I feel I must be a little bit confused. I must be missing out on something here, guys. This is the manager who is constantly being linked with moves to Everton whenever there's a job come up. Moves to West Ham whenever a job comes up. I mean, he's being linked with Arsenal, for God's sake, and Tottenham. What the hell? He must have some very good connections in the media. Yes, hello, David. Can you put my name out there? What's that for, Eddie? KFC? Manager's position? No, for Tottenham job. You know, because I've done such a good job here at Bournemouth, haven't I? Eddie, it's a bit difficult because you're not doing that good, mate. I mean, your bubble has burst a little bit lately. Yeah, but, you know, if you could just link me with a Tottenham job, people will believe I'm doing better than what I am. They'll ignore our current position, if you know what I mean. It's not going well for Eddie, and I believe if Bournemouth fans want a chance of staying up, you need to push for the sacking of the lad. It's all well and good having like stability, or rather loyalty. Look, he brought us up through the divisions, we've got to stick with him. You don't, trust me, that's not the answer. The answer is to keep your club up. Because if a big club come in for Eddie Howe in 2 years' time, if he starts doing well, he'll be off like a rocket. Trust me on that one. You need to stick by your fans and give them what they want, which is fun football. I mean, we all know what they do in the cups. I did have a list of that somewhere, but I've not got it on me now. They can't have every cup competition possible. He just hates the cup competitions. FA Cup against Altrincham at home. Who cares? We'll throw that one away. League Cup against bloody Bolton at home. Who cares? We don't want that one. They just do not give a damn about doing well in the cup competitions. Never have done while it's been the Premier League. Next, Villa. Now, I wrote this before their victory over Burnley. But I had Villa lose again. And that was when they lost 3-0 to Watford. Away from home. And Watford were down to 10 men for the majority of that game. I do believe Dean Smith is in over his head in the Premier League. They did a Fulham at the beginning of the season. They were signing everyone and anyone at Villa. And now they're talking about needing even more players. Heaton is out for the rest of the season. Wesley is out for the end of the season. There's talk about getting Michy Batshuayi on loan. Maybe with a John Terry-Chelsea connection, they can get that off of the line. They desperately need new players. I don't even just mean to replace them two either. I mean just to improve the squad in general. Trezeguet's done well. El Ghazi's done well. Grealish obviously done really well. John McGinn being injured, that's a huge blow. He was their best player. Darren Mings is back now, but I don't think he's the answer to keep you in the Premier League, in honesty. Wait there. Cheddar. Shh. two losses, one win, two losses, and they could eventually be found out by the end of the season. Should there be an age cap, age cap on Premier League managers? That's the next question here, guys. I'll explain to you why my bloody pen is not working. No, it is. Thank you. Explain to you why I'm asking that question. Roy Hodgson is 72 years old. Hear me there. 72. Pellegrini, when he was up until being sacked recently, was 66 years old. Surely these days we're seeing with Klopp, with Pep, with Lampard, Arteta now, Ollie, Poch when he was in Tottenham. It has to be a younger man's job. Yeah, it just has to be. He cannot be 72 and be in charge of such an important business. Like, in any other business in the world, apart from being president of the United States, you could not run such an important company or, be such an important leader at 72 years old. You'd be shown the door. Look, mate, you're 65. Time to go and put your slippers on, do a jigsaw, and smoke a pipe. But no, not in the in football. 72. Yeah, that's the new 34. Carry on, Roy. You must be down here. Bear in mind, he's working with kids. He's working with young players. Players who are young enough to be his grandkids. Or even great-grandkids, maybe. And they expect him to be on a level with those players. And I mean, I know he's got them playing all right, but you cannot teach an old dog new tricks. If I've got a dog and he's 72, I'm not able to teach him how to roll over if he's never done it before. You can't teach Roy Hodgson how to play a new style. So if Palace is happy to continue rolling on season after season, show no ambition, guys, all right, as long as we stay up, Royal do, yeah, it's okay. Royal keepers in the Premier League again. Well, eventually they'll get found out. I still can't get my head around Roy Hodgson. When England were knocked out of the World Cup, wasn't it, to Iceland, and he'd been sacked. We all knew that. And he came into his press conference and he was asked to explain along the lines of why the hell he had England's best striker and their top striker even now, Harry Kane, taking corners every single game. Why do you not want him in the box to put in the back of the net? And Roy's like, I don't know why I have to explain anything to you lot. I was like, mate, you've just been paid exorbitant amounts of money over the last few years. You've just gone out at the World Cup to Iceland, and you don't see why you need to explain anything to the people, to the fans, who've travelled over there to watch the World Cup. What a joke. I mean, the nerve of the man is ridiculous. And I'll never get me around that one. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. Saying Man United will be looking at recruiting new centre. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer has come out and said he wants to get some new central midfielders in this window. This is the same Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, remember, who was going on non-stop beginning of the season. He wants to give youth a chance. He wants to try some of the kids. We have James Garner. We have Teeth Chong. We have Angel Gomez. They're all three of them playing midfield. I believe that maybe Ollie was blowing a lot of smoke up our arses. I want to play the Man United way. I want to bring you through. I want to give the kids a chance. It all sounded nice and pretty when he was saying it. It really did. But now the time has come and he don't want to do it. McTominay, that was an easy one. He'd already been given his chance by Mourinho over and over again. He was already a regular in the team. It was easy to keep him in there. season, and Van Dijk or a Robertson, Trent Alexander-Arnold, they would really struggle. So if, when they win the league this season, next season, they do need to add to their depth of squad. To go Shaqiri as well, haven't they? But he went on the bench. I don't know if he was injured. Not too sure. I've seen him a couple of days ago at Melwood, welcoming the new signing, so I don't think he is injured. I'm not sure. Anyways, Championship promotion and winners. I'm going West Brom to win the Championship this season, and Leeds and Sheffield Wednesday to be promoted also. But I say that, I did this list before Wednesday dropped points in their last two games. They lost to Hull, didn't they, on the weekend, cost me my bet. I'm sure they lost the week before as well, so they need to turn that around, get back to some good form. But definitely West Brom and Leeds to go up. Premier League relegation, I've gone with Villa, Bournemouth and Norwich. Norwich, I know they got the result against Spurs on the weekend, but they are literally just plodding along before their next defeat. Not enough goals going forward and too many being conceded. Bournemouth, I can't wait to say goodbye. Bye-bye, Bournemouth. I feel sorry for their fans, I do. Eddie Howe does my head in. Champions League. Now, I've gone through the next this upcoming round and give my predictions on who will win which matches. So, Atletico Madrid, Liverpool. I'd probably go for Atletico, but I just think you don't back against Liverpool these days. Dortmund, PSG. PSG to go through. Atalanta, Valencia. Atalanta to go through. When they did just batter AC Milan in their last league game, 5-0. Tottenham, Leipzig. Tottenham to get through thanks to Mourinho. Chelsea, Bayern. Chelsea to go through. Napoli, Barcelona. Barca to get through. Lyon, Juve. Juve to go through. Real Madrid, Man City. I'm going with Real Madrid. I just think Pep does have in him these days to win the Champions League. That's my opinion. And got far in the Champions League in years. The eventual winners, I've gone with PSG or Liverpool. That's my thoughts on that one anyways. Transfers, possible transfers to happen this year. So not in January, but at the end of the season. One I need to add to this. Chelsea just had a £34 million bid for Moussa Dembele of Lyon turned down. I'm not surprised they turned it down. They paid Celtic £20 million for him. Why the hell they only want to accept a £14 million profit? You will not get this lad for less than £50 million. And rightly so. You know, when you look at the price of players around the world, why should they lose out just because they're Lyon? Possibly Mbappe to move to Real Madrid at last in this summer. A lot of money I need to swap hands, but Real Madrid spent a lot of money on Luka Jovic. Has not worked in the slightest. How embarrassing for that lad. They're doing well in Spain, but without actually being prolific. I think Mbappe would be that big signing that they need. Because Hazard was never going to be the big signing. He's not going to be an El Clasico signing. Hazard isn't. Not at his age, anyways. Neymar, where to? I've gone with Man City. Barcelona signed Griezmann. I know they were still after Neymar. But I think Griezmann's hardly fitting in that team right now. Griezmann, Dembele, not really getting in. He's injured, but when he was fit, they couldn't really get in around that team. Is so disjointed, the Barcelona lineup is, that adding Neymar to it, I don't think is in their plans right now. Pogba to Juve. I hope it happens. I don't know if it will, but I hope to God it does. With Raiola coming out the last couple of days saying, look, he needs to play for a team winning things. You just need to play, mate. Forget winning things. You just need to actually be fit for more than 2 days. Ollie. Yeah, I feel a bit sick today. Alright, Paul, don't worry, have a week off. Ollie, I've broken my big toe. have 6 weeks off. This 6 week break is coming to an end. I think I'm going down with depression. Yeah, it's just the weather. The weather's not good. I've been in Dubai for 6 weeks, and I think I need to stay here for another 6 weeks to get off of my depression. You stay there, Paul. We'll pay you $300,000 or $400,000 a week. Don't you worry about a thing. Stay there. Ben Chilwell to Chelsea or Tottenham. There's no doubt in my mind. Jose wants some new fullbacks. He does not trust Danny Rose. Ben Davis is injured. He's played Sessegnon on the left back last couple of games, but he wants to play further forward. He's already said that. Right back, we never replaced Kyle Walker or Kieran Trippier, rather. They are using Aurier there, who he does not trust. Ben Chilwell is a possibility. I'd also like to see Pereira, the Leicester right back in Spurs, great player. But Chelsea also need a full back as well, left back. And Chilwell has been linked with him, as he has Man City as well. I've actually wrote here, Pereira to Tottenham, forgot to write that down. Aguero, John Stones, Fernandinho and Walker all to leave Man City. Is that really too for stretching it too far? In my opinion, not. All of these players are pretty much past their best for Man City. Aguero, you know, they rely more on Jesus these days. John Stones, if that lad hasn't already considered leaving, I don't know he's playing at. Fernandinho, because he's getting older, obviously. And Carl Walker, remember when he was worth 50 odd million and everyone said, yeah, what a great signing. Well, that lasted like one season. Now he's not even in the England team, whether it be a centre back or right back. Trent Alexander-Arnold is the future of England, obviously, you know. And Walker is going to take a back seat, mate, I'm afraid, because you've also got Aaron Wan-Bissaka coming through as well at United. And the last one, the last possible transfer we have is, who's that? Oh yeah, Traore. Armand Traore, the Wolverhampton muscle buster. I mean, he is like a rhino on speed. Traore is at Wolves, but he dogs barking. And I've got him down for Liverpool or Man United. If he went to Liverpool, forget it. You would not see them for dust for the next few years. If he went to United, hell yeah. I mean, we've been lopsided on the right side now for years. I can't remember the last right-sided player we had was Ronaldo. That's how long we're going back here. Like, they tried Lingard out there, tried Juan Mata out there, tried Pereira out there. They've never had a natural right-sided player since Ronaldo. So if they've got Armand Traore in, hell yeah. But I live in Wolves, I'm a Wolves fan as well. Yeah, not ahead in my first team. Tottenham have always wanted to do well, and Wolves, because I'm in the air, I'll have to see them do well, and they'll probably beat United on the weekend in the FA Cup. I have to show some prediction video, shouldn't I? Oh well. But Traore, if he was to go to United, I would love to see that. I mean, he's like, he's like a small Brock Lesnar. He's absolutely huge, but I don't see him going to United. And whoever does go in for him, you're not going to get him cheap from Wolves. They know what they're doing at that club. It's just, hang on. Video. I said I will reveal it probably on Sunday of what my plan is from here on out in terms of the videos. So have a great day. Great kip. Thumbs up. Subscribe. Comment below. What's your thoughts on football? Who do you want to see your club sign? Do you think Eddie Howe is overrated, or am I just being harsh on him? Should Ollie be giving more chances to the kids? Have Liverpool as the beat.